session is Dr. Thi Thi Khutung. She is presently working as associate professor in the Department of Botany, University of Mandalay, Myanmar, and she did her graduation honors and post-graduation in botany from Mandalay University, and she also has been the senior visiting student of China Scholarship Council, and she studied at Zhongping University, China. Her area of expertise is rice, and today she will be speaking on the topic comparison of vegetative growth and some yield traits of perennial rice line 25. Ma'am, you have 12 to 15 minutes to speak and to present your work, please. You are most welcome, ma'am. Floor is yours.
Thank you. Let me share my screen.
Yeah, please.
To all ladies and gentlemen, Mingalama. My name is Thithi Thon. I'm an associate professor from University of Mandalay, Myanmar. Today, I would like to present comparison of vegetative growth and some year trends of perennial rice line 25. Nowadays, the world population continues to grow and it's required to increase the production of food from pure resources. Myanmar is one of the agriculture countries and rice is important staple food for Myanmar peoples. So, it is necessary to expand rice cultivation and in addition, rice production techniques are required. Many researchers have conducted experiments on perennial rice cultivation. According to their books, perennial rice cultivations have many advantages, such as sustainability of the grain yield, reduced fertilizer loss, reduced risk for farmer, lower labor requirements, less water needed and protecting soil from erosion. A successful perennial rice breeding program has been established in Yunnan University and re-evaluation of PR23 has been done in 9 ecological regions of Yunnan province in China. Yunnan University is now cooperating internationally, especially Southeast Asia countries. In Myanmar, the perennial rice from China is not testing and releasing, so to do this research work. Planning AMM objectives. The AMM objectives of this research work is to compare the vegetative growth and yield characters of PR25 growing in two seasons to examine the regrowth and adaptation of PR25 in Mandalay region. And I would like to set materials and method. The experiment was conducted at URC, a University Research Center of my university, University of Mandalay. The annual temperature, the average annual temperature and rainfall of Mandalay regions are 27 degrees Celsius and about 32 inches in 2019. The perennial rice grain collected from Research Center of Perennial Rice Engineering and Technology in Yunnan, School of Agriculture, Yunnan University, China. In this experiment, Complete randomized design rescues comprising 5 perennial rice lines with 10 replications. This figure showed for first season experiment. Firstly, the 3 days old germinated seed of germinated seed of perennial rice 25 rice lines were sowing in nursery trays, and 20 days after sowing, the seedling was transplanted into the pot. 30 days after transplanting, the plant height, tiller numbers, numbers of leaf plants were measured, and the data was collected every 15 days. The numbers of panicle length, number of spikelet per panicle and 1,000 grain weeks were also measured. For second season, let's continue there. At first season harvesting, the stubble was cut into 15 centimeters and the plants were allowed to regrow and regrowth was consistent. The data of second season were collected and compare with the first season result. For data analysis, student details were used. I would like to see the result in discussion. This table shows the data collected for plant growth every 15 days. This 15 days day by day. This table shows comparison of plant growth and yield in two seasons. The results show that the plant height, panicle length, number of spikelet per panicle were higher first season than second season. In the number of tiller, numbers of leaves are plants, panicle bar plants were lower first season than second season. The 1,000 grain weights were almost the same in two seasons, and the quality of grain is also good. The 15% flowering time was studied at 68 days after transplanting for first season. For second season is 83 days after first season cut off. The harvesting time in first season is more earlier than second season for going to this set. This figure shows the progress of PR25 every 15 days. A2F is for first season and C2K is for second season. And F is after step cut off 15 centimeters and K is the second season step cut off. According to Raza, PR25 was compatible with Mendeley region and it will continue in field experiment for further information. In 2020, the field trials continued in Mendeley regions. These photos show perennial rice line are grown in Mendeley station. This experiment is currently underway. So, I would like to express very thankful to Research Center of Perennial Rice Engineering and Technology in Yunnan for their provided financial support for our perennial project. And this is with my co-author, thankful to you all. This is my references for this PowerPoint. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Thay. It was really good to know the yield comparison of this crop, particularly the rice, in which you just pointed out one variety, that is line 25. It's really good to know the way you started, you know, the world need more food because the population is increasing. And it is very important to increase the yield just to feed the growing population. And the more yield is to be grown so that we can do something good in coming time. Comparing with the vegetative cover and growth in the yield character in your laboratory, it is good to know that the way you conducted this research at the University Research Center by just randomizing the design with 10 replication. I think it is good to consider that if you are replicating any experiment for 10 times, then the result can be considered as validated. And the way in the last slides you just show the yield which has increased, that is equal to two season. It is good to know that in